Hello everyone, this is Ted with OAXRAY, and today we're going to go over how you can make money selling products on Amazon that you find on Sears.com. Before we get started on Sears.com, we want to go check out Raise and Ebates. There are other websites that give you discounted gift cards, so you can check those also, but I just happen to like Raise. So here we are, and we're going to get 5.6% off on Raise. Now, if we scroll over to Ebates and we type in Sears, we see here that we get 1.5% cash back. So our total cash back today is going to be about 7%, so we want to make sure we put that in our discount field. Now, here we are on Sears.com. I want to make sure some of my settings are correct, so I'm going to right-click OAXRAY, and I'm going to click on Options. So once we are on the Options page, I'm going to turn on the Shopkeeper stats on, and once you have that on, I'm going to hit Save. This is just going to show you historical data based on the Keeper stats. Now, once I'm on Sears, I can go to any category I want. I've been looking at men's watches just because I like categories that are gated. You have a little bit less competition. So I'm going to go into men's watches. There seems to be a 30% discount or higher on a lot of these watches. Here I am on a page. I'm going to scroll to the bottom of it on Sears, because if you don't scroll to the bottom, it's not going to show you all the listings for this page. So here I am. I'm going to left click on the OAXRAY extension, and it's going to bring up another page for me to look at. Now, while that's loading, I can go on to page 2. I'm going to scroll down, and I'm going to run OAXRAY again. So when you first get to OAXRAY, this is what it will look like. We can see that some items have a negative ROI. Those are the items that are red on my screen. Some items are green, those have a positive ROI. And on my screen, these items right here, this item right here, which is kind of a teal color, that has no listings on Amazon.com. Once we hit positive ROI, we get a screen like this, which removes anything that's not positive, anything that might not have a match. From here, we can hover over the Amazon price and get a good Keeper graph, which will show us the last time the item was in stock in new. As we can see, it's been a while since this item has been in stock. We can also see the image here if we hover over the Sears pricing information, and we see that those items look the same. We can also see with the Keeper information that the item has a review. We can also see the average price for the last 30 days, 90 days, and overall average sales rank. We can also see the current sales rank, the category, the weight, the fee, the net profit, and the ROI. From here, I'll click on the Amazon listing and click on the Sears listing. Make sure those items match and start evaluating this purchase. So I'll look on Sears first, make sure the item's in stock. Looks like it's in stock. It's on some type of clearance here. And I'll get a really good look at the image to make sure it matches Amazon. Just from the image, it looks like this item matches Amazon perfectly. And one thing that's important to me would be the reviews. So here we see that there are 47 reviews for this item. Seems 50% of these are... just about 50% are 5-star, 32% are 4-star, and really what's dragging down the reviews is these 11%, which are 1-star. Pretty good ranked item. Most of the reviews are 4 or 5, so I'd probably be okay with buying this. Whenever I look at the Keeper data, this item hasn't been in stock for a while. So even though the rank is high, it hasn't been in stock for a while. So once we put some items in stock, we might see a bounce from that, especially because there's so many reviews on this product. So I would at least give this item a try. Looks like we have no new item in stock. And with watches, people are definitely looking for the new. If I were going to sell this new, I'd probably try 110 and see if I got the buy box for this item. Maybe even throw in some sponsored ads if I needed to get the sales rank up, so I'd just get a little bit more exposure. Before you purchase anything, I always like to click sell on Amazon and add it to a shipment just to make sure, especially with the recent gating of some items. So if you don't see this button, it is possible that maybe this item is restricted for you. Or if you see that the item is restricted anywhere on the screen, then before you purchase this, make sure you investigate that. Whenever I come over to the fee calculator, I see something strange. I haven't seen this before, which is an inventory alert. And it says Amazon may have sufficient levels of this ASIN. The strange part about this is Amazon's not selling this and there are no FBA sellers. So I'm not sure if this item is going to be restricted. That's why I always recommend adding it to a shipment. So my Amazon price, if I was pricing this, would be 110. Throw it up there at 110 and see what we came out with. My prep fees are probably going to be about $2.50. So I'm going to put that there. Now you have to remember, I'm going to buy this item for $45.50. I'm going to get approximately 8% off. So I'm going to put in a buy cost of 41, and I'm going to see what we come out with in the calculation. Now, if we're able to purchase this item for $45.50, we get the cash back and we get the raised discounts. We're going to pay about $41. So that's what I'm putting in this box. My prep service field, I'm going to put in $2.50. Now that's going to include all my costs. That's going to include if I need to polybag it or somehow specifically wrap this box. I'm going to need to ship it inbound. I want to make sure I account for all my costs. So I'm going to guess a little bit high on this one and say it's about $2.50 to prep this item. If you're sending it to a prep center, you'll have a pretty easy feel for how much this is actually going to cost you because they charge you a specific fee. But you want to make sure you account for your own time if you're prepping this item yourself. So I'm going with $2.50. Looks like I'm going to a little bit more than double my items. Now, just a quick overview. We want to make sure first that the items match perfectly. Look for multi-packs. Sometimes an item is a pack of three on Amazon and it's a pack of one on Sears. So we want to be clear that we know the exact quantity we're selling on both websites so we get our buy cost correct. Make sure we click sell on Amazon and we're able to add the item to a shipment. There have been recent restrictions and I want to make sure that everybody knows what they're getting into before they purchase the item. Check out the customer reviews, see what people are saying about this item. That can make a huge difference in whether it sells or not. If you find an item that has no sales rank but it has multiple reviews, that probably means Amazon's suppressing the sales rank, but people seem to still be buying it based on the customer reviews. In my experience, for every 50 to 100 people who buy an item, one will leave a feedback. You can compare the customer reviews with the date at which the item was first available, and you can kind of see how many are selling per month, kind of an estimate based on that amount. You can also go to OAXRAY, hover over the Amazon price, and you can check past Keepa data to see the last time items were in stock and kind of get a gauge there on the stock levels. You can also put in a discount here. So today our discount was 8%, and if you do that, it will recalculate the ROI net profit. If you only want to see the positive ROI items, you just click on positive ROI items. If you only want to see items that meet your My Buy criteria, click on My Buys and it's going to filter that. If you want to put in a per pound fee, sales tax, or a per unit fee, you can also put in a per pound fee of $1. It's going to take those costs in considerations when it's calculating the ROI net profit. We can also put in a per pound fee or per unit fee of $1 if you're sending it to a prep center. After watching this video, you should now be able to use OAXRAY on Sears.com. Thank you guys very much. Have a great day and make some money using OAXRAY.